Shawano County Library's Gardening Tips and Tricks. My name is Pam, and today we are going to make a do-it-yourself mosquito repellent planter. So the first thing you're going to need is a pretty sizable planter, and the flowers that I picked out that are going to work best for this are 3 3-packs of marigold, a couple of lavender plants, 2 rosemary plants, and then this in the back here is a lemongrass for a little bit of height in the back. So as we all know, summers are really for beaches, barbecues, and of course the bugs. The pesky bugs really love me, but I have found a really great way to go ahead and combat them, and that is with this planter. So just starting out, I'd like to drop a disc in the bottom of my planter that will aid in drainage. In addition to that, I have several plastic containers that I like to put down in the bottom of my planter. It lightens it up a little bit so you're not wasting all of your potting mix down in the bottom. I've just got some old berry containers. You can see me putting in there some containers from plants themselves. Probably I fill it up about halfway in the bottom before I start to add my gardening mix to it. So this is just a compressed pack of premium moisture potting mix, and we're just going to go ahead and place some of that in the bottom. If you're working with an especially large planter like I am, you may want to add another container or two. So I'm just going to tap my lavender out here and drop another container or two in there. So lavender is a really, really great bug repellent. It contains about 25% linalool oil, and that is an oil that is known to ward off the mosquitoes. It's commonly known as DEET. That's what probably most of us know the product as. So one more container I'm going to just drop in there. Again, we want to keep this light. So this is going to be for a sunny area. You're going to want to have this container placed near doors or windows to repel the mosquitoes. And when I say a full sun or a sunny area, that constitutes about 6 to 8 hours of direct sunlight per day. Just come around to the other side here, and we'll continue to fill that up. Certainly you don't have to go with a compressed product, but it stores in my garage a lot nicer. You can go with any type of high moisture potting mix. So I would say probably fill that up about 3/4 of the way with your dirt. And as I mentioned, the scent of the lavender is really offensive to mosquitoes, but of course we love it. It will bloom in a purple color, so it's really pretty, a nice color combination with the rosemary as well as with your marigold. So let's go ahead and start off placing the plants tallest to shortest in your planter. So my lemongrass is going to be the tallest. I'm going to pop that in the back. The lemongrass can also be cut and used as a cooking product as well. Then I'm going to go ahead and situate my 2 lavender plants kind of to the side. Oh, that's my rosemary. My 2 lavender plants to the side, and these will fill in. They should flower in about 3 weeks or so, followed by my 2 rosemary plants. Rosemary is an herb, so again, in addition to this repelling the mosquitoes, you can also snip just little pieces off of this and use them all in cooking. Dried lavender can be placed in wardrobes or in your drawers. It will keep the moths away as well. And then lastly, we're just gonna pop some marigolds in towards the front of our pot. I've got some of the orange and yellow ones here. Certainly there's different heights and different colors. Just mix those up. Good. Once you've got all of your plants placed in there, go ahead and continue to fill that in with dirt. Again, I would place this plant in a sunny location that it's going to get 6 to 8 hours of sunlight per day. This should take you all the way through summer, through a hard frost as well. In a couple of weeks, that lavender will be in full bloom, and hopefully those mosquitoes won't be bothering you any longer. There we go. So go ahead and water that in real well. I'm gonna go ahead and pop a stake in there. One of my girlfriends gave this to me as a gift. My friend Penny, because she knows we love honeybees and that my husband and I are beekeepers. So, voila. Again, situated by your entrance or your exit to keep the mosquitoes and other pests away. Thanks for joining us today.